Hello, Athens, and happy Charity Week. I'm Mr. Burns. I'm the teacher of the Athens TV class, and I want to thank you so much for attending the Athens TV Charity Film Festival. We are in our 11th year of Athens TV, and we had intended to do a celebratory retrospective last year, but of course, COVID. So we shifted it to this year, to today, to now, a 10-year celebration of Athens TV. We'll be looking back in this film festival at some of the award-winning films, the awkward classics, the genuinely moving documentaries that have made a difference in the world. If you're ever interested in joining Athens TV, you're more than welcome. The best relationships I've built at Athens have come in this room, and there's nothing better than watching someone hit export on a project, the finished product that came from nothing more than an idea in their head. Whatever Athens TV is from year to year is fully dependent on what you, the students, want to make of it. If you want to see yourself up here at the 2023 Film Festival, then sign up for Writing for Broadcasting and Advanced Writing for Broadcasting during scheduling, which opens soon. Both classes are repeatable and count as English credits, and the possibility of friendships, awards, and glory are endless. Boombox kicks off our first set of videos, all with a focus on the awkward humor that has laid the foundation of Athens TV and all it has become. Enjoy.
Imagine in your mind a posh country club, the stuffy old money where the poor get snubbed. The spread is bland, sauerkraut and boiled goose. There's no way these people will ever cut loose. But then I walk in the room, hold my boombox high, and what happened next will blow your mind.
Everything got out of control, the music was so entrancing. Everyone got out on the floor, it was a bunch of old white people dancing.
Now picture, if you will, a bunch of businessmen stuffed in the boardroom like pigs in a pen. The ties around their necks are like a hangman's noose. In the middle of the table there's a boiled goose. The old people smell makes you wanna puke in the sink. These dudes will never dance, yeah, that's what you think. I stride in the room all young and hip, hold up my boombox and say, listen to this.
Then everyone started to move, people rejoice instead of financing. Your frequency and notions were shattered by the super old white people dancing.
A big apple where people never dance. Spirits go down while profits expand. The cops or the dealers, who's got the juice? The street vendors peddling their boiled goose. So many types of people, they'll never get along. Till I bust out my boombox and play this song.
The music washed away all the hate, and society started advancing. Every demographic was represented. It was a rainbow coalition of dancing.
Unity, a feeling essential to the high school experience. Whether it's old friends catching up, or a student and teacher eager to learn from each other, the unity at Athens is on display around every corner. But there is nothing else that can compare such unity than through our beloved Athens Red Hawk. He penetrates the consciousness of bored students in class. Just look at this beautiful bird, so graceful, so understanding, so red. Go ahead, it's okay to stare. And who cares if we're accused of stealing a red hawk from somewhere else? For this is a school of many hawks, and all hawks belong here. Red hawks come in many different shapes and sizes. they can be found anywhere, including on this kid. His name is Patrick. And what many people don't know is that the Red Hawk doesn't live in the wild. They are all bred in captivity by Mr. Keolian. Go ask him for one. They make great pets. So come and fly with our Red Hawks and become a part of the Unity at Pure Athens.
Son of a bee sting! No one ever does anything in this class.
This is grim, real grim.
What are you gonna do?
There's only one thing a man can do when he's suffering from a spiritual and existential funk.
Throw the freshman in the dumpsters?
No. Buy new suits!
Yeah! That girl.
I'm gonna make a mind if it takes all night. Can you dig it? Can you dig it? Can you dig it? Can you dig it? Now that girl.
We've been walking for 45 minutes.
Yeah, Mike, I thought you said this is a shortcut.
Fantastic.
Is it a shortcut or not?
Okay.
Uh-oh. Here comes trouble.
Keep it tight, prisoner. Keep it tight, prisoner.
Well, well, well. If it isn't the big, bad, new news team. Where's your mommy? I heard Mr. Burns came in. I heard he makes all your videos. Writes all your scripts. I heard he changes your diapers. I heard he rubs Vaseline all over your sweet hiney and tell you it's different from everybody else's.
You said hiney. Mike, get over here.
I've had enough of you, Joe. This is gonna end right here, right now. Let's dance, scumbag.
I don't wanna dance. I wanna polka. All right, let's do this.
Let's do this.
Mike, where'd you get a chicken?
I don't know.
Not so fast, you ingrates. Last year's news team is taking a break from college to come back and kick some. But, no curfew, no mercy!
Okay, let's go over some ground rules. Rule one, no touching of the hair of the face.
Of course.
That's it! Let's do this!
I was talking to this girl, and you know, she was looking real good. I'm like, yo, hit me up on Twitter, you know, what's happening? You know, what's happening? Like, really, yo, what's happening? Like, yo, what's happening? What's...
Wait, we get it, bro. What was happening?
No, you guys don't get it. I was like, yo, what's...
Come with me if you don't want to die.
Dead?
I'm afraid so, but forget about him for right now. We gotta get ourselves out.
Out? What do you mean?
There it is! What the heck is going on?
The boss must have figured out how to get inside us and eliminate us from the human race. They're targeting the tools.
So how do we know who's next?
Probably he's next, the one with the jersey. Athens sucker's full of tools.
Classic BG.
What can I say? I know the ball's rules.
Yeah, buddy.
Stop, man. You killed it.
Whoa. Oh, hold on.
Yeah. You thought I was a bro. Now I'm a ball.
Sometimes, something beautiful happens in this world.
TV.
You don't know how to express yourself,
and
so
all the nominees,
you just gotta sing.
I aced that test, and it felt so good.
Felt so good.
I never knew that getting smart was possible. I aced that test, and I'll never go back to the not acing test ways of the
real smart, used a tie, Ticonderoga.
Yeah.
My mom knows I did it. She saw it when she checked headline. Now there's no question that'll get my diploma.
Never guess what I just did. I aced that test.
Yeah.
If I had to describe the feeling, it was the best. And Keolian thought I cheated, but no. I'm just very lucky when guessing true or false.
Hey guys, guess what I just did? I just got a B.
Are you joking? You are stupid and obscene.
You brought lots of great shame on your family name.
Go and study, Ziegenfelder. You're lame.
I aced that test. And it felt so good.
Felt so good.
I never knew that getting smarter was possible. I wanna tell the world.
To be honest, I'm surprised they even scored above a 90. Can you go to college now? Don't know, maybe. I'm not one to argue with a good thing. Now my grade is fine. That good? As high as the hair on Genuine.
Now I'm taking beatings from the tools for being such a smarty.
But honestly, it was worth the awesome pizza party.
And now today my GPA is higher. You can bet it.
It's because we brought in Kleenex for the extra credit.
So this one's dedicated to the nerds that try to get an A on all their tests. Never expect less from the NHS. We want to thank you all for boosting the average.
I was talking on my phone,
but I still aced that test.
My pencil broke 8 times,
but I still aced that test.
I might have cheated off the Katie,
but I still aced that test.
I got the key by mistake.
Still counts.
I aced that test, and my dreams came true.
So if you ace the test, says the last card marking, then you qualify to sing with me.
I aced that test. And it felt so good. I never knew that getting smarter was possible. I aced that test, and I'll never go back to the not acing test ways of the past.
Everybody was tense till Ryan scored a goal, then did it again with another by Rishi in between. Oh, what a season for this team. Now Coach Hugh has won it all for a second time this year as a coach and also as a player in 89. That was way, way, way before any of these guys were even born. There's a long, long, long tradition behind these uniforms. 81, 83, 84, 89, 97, now 2019. They've been the best team in all of was so much fun. How about next year we do it again?
Turn down for what?
Hi, I'm Ellie. I'm the leader of the A-line. My mother is the founder of the A-line, and the family tradition has been passed down ever since. Ever since I was a little girl. Oh, my mom just sent me this picture of me and Carmela. Ellery recently moved here from Texas, but as soon as she got here, I could just tell that she was an A-liner.
I believe. Nice job.
Hi, I'm Emma. I'm on the line because I can run really fast away from anything.
I'm the E in the A-line, and without me, it would just be the A-line, so I guess you could say I'm pretty important.
I heard everybody wants to be on the A-line. It must suck to be on the outside.
I'm Grant. Oh, it's my sixth year trying out for the squad. I've been cut every single year. I mean, I put a lot into the team, 110% every day, and they just don't want me, and I can't help it. I come to the game. Every game, painted as an L. For 6 years and they don't want me. They don't want me. Carmela, please let me be on the squad.
Hi, my name is Harry. I'm pretty a big deal here. I've gotten the most important person award 5 times, so I mean, kind of like, for what?
I've never gotten a most important person award, but Ellery and Ellie said that I'd be a pretty good candidate.
My name's Brendan. They only use me for the bed of my truck.
Caught red-handed. Today, we have received multiple videos of a car crash involving the famous influencer Big Ounce. Two friends and a lone man caught footage of the miraculous event on their cell phone cameras. You could say the friends had a front row seat.
Yo, is that Big Ounce? Yo, that's Big Ounce. I gotta record this.
The driver here spots the internet star and decides to record his sighting. Taking his hands off the wheel is his first mistake. He then proceeded to send the video recordings to his friend. To do so, his head is now facing down away from the direction the car is moving.
I'm sending this to Shane.
Young man, watch out!
Oh!
Boom! Disaster has struck for the man behind the wheel. Because he wasn't focused on the road ahead, he crashed into the individual that he was so excited to see.
Oh man, oh shoot! Oh god!
Big Ounce, are you alright?
From my Bubba Chuck jersey, man.
Now, I know what you were thinking. Because of your viewing of previous interviews, that guy looks a lot like me. But I can assure you, it is not me. Both this random guy and I are victims of being extremely handsome.
Young man, are you okay?
That ain't what I asked. Is my jersey all right?
It's okay. It
doesn't look too... Text it, bro.
In conclusion, this reckless driver was indeed caught red-handed when texting and driving. Before we go, Big Ounce wanted to say a few words to the viewers.
Yo, Big Ounce says don't text and drive.
Well, our buckets certainly aren't filled by you yakking over there.
Yes! Yes! Guys, check it out.
I'm a yak.
Yakking, I'm a yak.
He's a yak.
I'm yakking.
Guys. I'm riding the yak.
I'm riding the yak.
I'm a yak.
I'm feeding the yak. I'm feeding the yak. Feed the yak.
Whoa, guys, check it out. A key.
Hey. Yaks don't talk, Michael!
A key?
It's a key.
Wait! What do you guys think, bro?
It could open anything.
Let's go check it out!
Let's get out of here!
You guys are so dear to me.
Whoa, what did I say?
Dear.
Deer.
Check it out. I'm a deer.
I ain't lying about that. Oh, lying. Oh.
I don't understand.
Oh, hey, I'm a lion.
Roar. Look at this kid, he's a lion.
guys, look at me. I'm riding the lion.
I'm riding the lion. Get out of here.
Yeah, I'll see you clowns in the key 4, 5, and 6.
Cranky. Why are you in such a bad mood?
Dude, obvious. My ball torn, and Mom will get me a new one. I'm crabby, okay? What? What's so funny?
Crab.
Oh, jeez. Look at me. I'm a crab.
Oh, check it out. I'm riding the crab.
Snip, snip.
Riding the crab.
I love you, Dad!
Video is the greatest storytelling medium ever created. And while we have most often utilized that medium for the aforementioned awkward humor, it's undeniable that student videos have made an impact in our community and beyond. With PSAs and documentaries, we've gone from our own homes all the way to Haiti to share stories that make a difference.
4.6 million American children and minors are living in homes with at least one loaded and unlocked firearm. 73% of children aged 9 and under reported knowing the location of their parents' firearms. 36% admitted that they had handled the weapons, including many whose parents had reported their children did not know the location of the firearm.
Texting back there, and I just want to make sure you don't do that as you get on the road, okay?
Yeah, I'll focus on the road, no problem.
You wouldn't want to turn your life into a horror movie. All right, have a good night.
Haitians in the Dominican Republic are heavily discriminated against. They are treated as second-class citizens by the majority.
En la República Dominicana, los dominicanos no tienen ni 1% de respeto a los haitianos.
Hasta que una piedrecita que tú eres un haitiano, lo primero que habla es de hacerte brujería, de hacerte daño, de quitarte la vida. Son gente negra, son gente que tienen el corazón sucio.
Que los haitianos le dan respeto, pero ellos no les dan respeto. Ellos nunca no quieren ver su país.
Ellos no quieren a los haitianos aquí porque los haitianos son perros.
Grayling's just an easy thing for everyone to love because it's such a beautiful fish.
From a morphological standpoint, it's built differently from fish we have.
They have this huge dorsal fin that has really beautiful colorations.
They're silvery, but they're iridescent, almost have a purple cast to them.
They're just different, and the fact that they were native to this region is really the thing that makes them special.
They were the cold water species, the salmonid in the northern lower peninsula. It was what fishing in Michigan was in the 1800s.
We were literally taking these fish and piling them up on banks 6 feet tall.
There wasn't a saw timber carrying tree left standing between Lake Michigan and Lake Huron.
A lot of these fish that are hugely popular nowadays, things like brown trout, brook trout, rainbow trout, they weren't here. We have this species that we know was here 100 years, you know, over 100 years ago, and it would just be really nice to have them back.
It's been attempted to reintroduce grayling in the past, and it failed each time. What we're really focusing on is trying to figure out what suitable fish communities grayling can survive in, but not only survive, but also thrive.
They're a touchstone to our conservation past.
It's kind of about doing the right thing, bringing back a species that was extirpated.
Now I love Athens, but one thing clear from those videos is things tend to be much more interesting when you are outside of Athens. Travel is something we try to work into the Athens TV experience, whether it's in pursuit of a story or just to experience something new. Pre-pandemic, we offered a travel scholarship to students to complete a video project. 1 year, as you're about to see, they visited all five Great Lakes in 1 day. Two others have visited New York City, and field trips to New York and Los Angeles are hopefully coming back once COVID subsides.
After London, Newcastle, York, Manchester and Sheffield, New York's the greatest city in the world, so I thought we'd go and see the sights. Let's go!
Hey, let's go!
Down in Tribeca, right next to the Narrow, but I'll be hood forever.
Look at the Statue of Liberty.
No way.
English invented the train. Yeah.
Oliver's like really smart. He knows everything.
Just like a seed in a garden, you will grow to be tall. Staring out over miles of land without it.
Try.
Comes together in short film, which requires talented directors, editors, actors, good locations, and above all, the right script. And we're going to wrap today with three of the best examples we have had.
What's up, subscribers? It's Zach Attack here on another episode. I'm in my fifth hour class right now. I'm about to prank old man Burns, man. He's a big fan of the Coca-Cola products, and he's going to get a funky taste in his mouth. He's coming right here.
What's up, guys? Hi. Oh, there.
Yeah, it's right there.
God, I've been looking all over for this. Gets me through the day.
Yeah.
What's this? What are you adding? It looks good.
Oh, it's just a video me and my boys are making.
I like it. Like it a lot.
Mr. Burns, how's it taste? How's it taste?
Well, it tastes like root beer. Who put root beer in
there? You just got torched!
Oh! I want to be on torched.
Hey, what up, YouTubers? It's KaiGuy212 here. I'm about to pull a mega prank on these guys. Watch, we're gonna turn the women's room
into the men's room.
Oh, 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 here she comes, here she comes. Oh. KaiGuy212 back in action here. We got this G-dub right here attached to this string. We're gonna catch some fools in action. Here she comes, here she comes, here she comes. KaiGuy212 back here with another huge prank. I'm gonna knock on the door and run away. Yeah.
Can I play with you?
I guess I'm just juggling, trying to get my touches in, but...
Great, thanks.
Gorged!
My skills!
What? Torched!
What the heck was that? Spilled all of my Skittles. He ruined my practice. Says something about torched?
Still no news on torched.
That was quite a prank you pulled.
You saw that?
I've seen a lot of you lately.
I've been getting a lot of attention from web series called Torched.
Oh, well, that's weird. The only hot thing I see around here is you. So are you going to take me to the prom or what? I'll pick you up.
Yes.
Foul weather. 7 o'clock.
What's up, loser? Hottest thing I've ever seen. Yeah, right. Torched. Oh, torched.
Whoa! Freeze frame on that loser's face. That's disgusting, Kyle Cole. Jeez. I never said anything like that in my whole life. I'm 17 years old and I don't even understand. Oh. Anyway, special shout out to Ashley and Ellie. A feature from Ellery Thill too as well. Great actress, that girl. Wow. Just props to her. I really couldn't do it myself. Congratulations, ladies. Great job. And Kyle Cole, you've been torched!
Torched!
Where's our cold medicine? No, Mom, it's not here. Just tell me where it is. No, I looked there, Mom. No! I don't want to go to Capitol. It's sketchy. Will you at least leave me the car? Fine, I'll ride my bike.
Hi, what can I get you?
Hey, can I get some gum, one of those chargers, and a pack of smokes?
Wait, what was that?
Pack of smokes.
No, before that.
Oh, chargers.
Oh, yeah. What color do you want?
Can I get the blue one?
Oh, yeah, sure. Here you go. Who's this?
Who's this?
11:34.
Perfect, thank you.
All right, man, you're all set.
Thanks.
Good. Hey, by the way, how old are you?
I'm 20.
All right. Hey man, what's up?
Can I just get this and some cold medicine?
Yeah. Wait, how old are you?
18.
I can't sell you that. You have to be at least 21 to buy that.
Alright, fine. You call me, I'm 19.
You think I'm some sort of idiot? That's still under 21.
Come on, man. I'm really sick. I just need some.
Dude, I'm sorry. I can't sell you that. I'll get in a lot of trouble.
Alright, well, where do you expect me to get some then?
I don't know. Go to like your local drug dealer or something. That's what I do.
Alright, just this.
Just that? Alright. Alright, you're all set.
Thanks. That's the stupidest rule ever. Hey, do you,
Huh?
You don't have any cold medicine at home?
No, we don't have any at home. And I went to the drugstore and they said they can't sell it to an underage kid because it's illegal.
It's ridiculous.
You know they can't sell to underage kids. You know what they do with that? They cook meth.
No.
Yeah? Have you heard? No, you know Clark, dude. Fifth Hour the other day, he was tripping on meth.
No, he was just sick. He had some bad chicken. And I took him down to the clinic, he was fine the next day.
Dude, I'm telling you, bro, it was meth. You seem pretty stuck though. What are you gonna do about it?
Well, the guy said I should ask my local drug dealer.
Well, drug you? That's a great idea, man.
Well, where am I supposed to find him?
I am just the guy. Drug, this is the guy to come to.
Dude, I think we need to get out of here.
No, stay. I'll introduce you. Well, get over here.
Hey, Nick. This is Will. What's it to me? He needs the stuff.
You know a guy?
Can he get some?
I don't know.
Is he worthy?
Are you worthy?
Seems worthy.
Indeed.
Listen, I know a guy. He's wandered around these parts.
The name's Scooter.
Behind the dumpster at 6 o'clock. He's always there. Go alone.
Let's get out of here, man.
There he is. We got this. We got this.
hell are you?
Will.
Will who?
Doesn't matter. Your Scooter, right?
Yeah, that's the name. Where'd you hear about me from?
That Nick guy, he sent me. I need
some. I gave him some stuff a while back. What do you need?
I need some cold medicine.
Cold medicine? How the hell do you need cold medicine?
Well, I can't buy it myself.
Just go ask your mom or something.
She's not home. I need cold medicine. I'm sick.
Dude, why are you asking me? I sell the hard stuff, bro.
Listen.
The hard stuff.
Listen, I'll pay you whatever you need. I just need some cold medicine.
Oh, shoot the bed!
You get over here!
He's going
get
that way! What's that way?
Get
that way!
He went that way.
Stop talking.
Turn around. Can't get on you. Did you know about?
No.
No?
No.
You sure?
Yes.
So what are you doing here?
Well, he was just giving me some cold medicine. I just need some cold
what?
Medicine. I have cold.
Cold medicine. Cold
yeah.
medicine?
Yeah.
What is that? Is that something new?
No.
Is that like a new drug?
I just need cold medicine.
Cold medicine? Is that
yeah.
like, what is that? Is that like new slang?
No, just cold medicine. I'm sick. I my mom couldn't buy me cold medicine. I'm underage. I just need
cold medicine. Like NyQuil?
Yes.
For real?
Yes.
All right, man. Come with me for a second. We'll get to the bottom of this. Yeah, right here. Ah, locked. Hold on a second. What? Bike theft? I don't got time for a bike theft. I'm here on a drug deal. Oh, man. Come on, man! Come back!
God, we're home today. Should just stay home.
I'm just going to bed.
I say tea. What do you think of? A tea party? A steaming pot of Earl Grey? A drink, right? Wrong. The tea is the drama. That everyday teenage angst materialized in gossip, rumor, and fractured relationships. When that tea is hot, look out. When that tea is spilled, though, well, don't be nearby. So how does the tea get spilled? What happens? Why do things that seem utterly inconsequential turn into a viral, life-destroying beast when placed in the teacup of a high school? I wanted to know, so I took a deep look in one such pivotal tea moment. I call it the incident at the pier, and it happened in Los Angeles. So, how did we get here?
The LA trip is legendary.
It's epic.
They say that LA is a once-in-a-lifetime thing, even though some people have gone twice.
The trip is organized by the TV class, and the idea is that you'll learn about the TV industry there and be inspired by something. Whatever, everyone knows it's to take Instagram pictures and Snapchat your friends.
What makes it Insta-conducive is you're all like, look at me in these palm trees, and like, oh, now I'm just casually hanging out in these sunglasses I just bought.
This is my life. What are you doing with yours?
I mean, I guess there's just some people who take it seriously, like Crazy H.
Crazy H is Grace Harward, an aspiring vlogger. She plays an important role in this story and she'll come up again, so remember the name. Now, one thing that came up in all of our interviews was the roster for this year's trip. For one thing, it was all juniors. That's unusual and important. When the trip has a cross-section of classes, there's respect. A respect born out of unease and unfamiliarity. When it's all one class, they bring their tea with them. And another thing.
Everyone was on that trip. I mean, it was loaded.
Sabrina, Abby.
Austin, Abby.
Abby and Sabrina.
Austin, Sabrina.
Sabrina, Abby.
Austin, Abby, Sabrina.
Of course there were others. But those three names, Sabrina, Abby, and Austin, came up on everyone's list. Which makes sense for the most part. Sabrina and Abby were best friends and roommates in LA. It was clear they set the tone and the agenda on the trip. For example, one night, according to several people, the plan was to go to Blaze Pizza. But at the last second, Sabrina and Abby decided everyone would go to Smashburger.
They got a lot of followers, I know that. They're like in the five digits. That probably means they got a lot of influence.
There's a Sabrina and Abby at every school. The girls who seem to have it all. Who can navigate the complex web of relationships and social norms to achieve power at the top. I expected them in their story. What I didn't expect, and what alters their story, Austin.
Austin's like really hot. I'm pretty comfortable saying that.
He's a bad boy. Great hair.
Hot.
It goes on like that. Maybe it's best to let Austin describe himself.
So tell us a bit about yourself.
I'm Austin.
Can you elaborate?
Yeah.
Those are our key players, but let's move on to our key storyteller, Grazy H, the trip vlogger. And other than scraps pulled from social media, it's her videos that give us the most reliable accounts of what happened. She, asked me to tell you to subscribe, smash the like button, and follow any links in the description on her videos. Here we go. So far, pretty standard, but then, at the Getty Center. I call this the Getty interview, and it's equal parts important and unclear. So I'll leave it to you. Do these two people, Abby and Jamie, look like they're in that giddy, just started dating phase?
But I have the new lovebirds over here. Jamie, do you love her?
Yeah, I love her.
What about you, Abby?
Maybe she just doesn't want to be on camera, but Abby doesn't strike me here as someone who is so in love with her new boyfriend. Jamie, though, he's either in love or not in on the joke. How you read Abby here may be influenced by this text. According to the timestamp, it was at 12:53, while the group was still at the Getty. Now, this is where things start to get complicated, because Austin had a busy trip.
Austin was holding hands with, like, everyone on the trip.
He's got the reputation of holding a lot of people's hands.
I'm pretty sure if you were a girl at one point, you were with Austin.
It's kind of impressive when you think about it. There were 17 girls on this trip.
And ironically, all but two of them can be reliably linked with Austin, Sabrina and Abby. I haven't forgotten about Sabrina. Based on the available evidence, she and Abby were having a really good time on the trip, most of it together. But there was still some trip left, and on the last day in Santa Monica is where things took a massive turn.
We're going to watch the sunset, but it was taking way too long, and we wanted to make sure we made it to the pier, so we left.
We were walking on the beach, and we were talking about college, and that's when she told me that she liked Austin. And I said that wasn't really a good idea because he'd been holding hands with every girl on the trip.
So I was all ready to go on the Ferris wheel with him, and out of nowhere, Sabrina cuts in front of me.
I did, I'll admit, I went on the Ferris wheel with him. But I didn't cut, I was pushed, and I would never, ever hold his hand.
In the immediate aftermath, what Abby thought was all that matters, she had a post on her Finsta before the Ferris wheel ride was even over. I asked her to read it, even if I can't play much of it.
Guess what? It's because you're a You're gonna get and there's it's just gonna happen. And yes, you, but hopefully you did.
And on it went, both the Finsta post and the freshly spilled tea. The fallouts were swift and far reaching.
Thank God it was the last night. There wasn't a word on the plane. It was so awkward.
From talking about being college roommates to no longer being on speaking terms in a matter of minutes. It seems impossible, but as always, there's more.
It all goes back to the 7th grade basketball team. She thinks that I'm jealous of her because she made it and I didn't. But in reality, she just cried after the tryout and her dad talked to the coach.
I know people can hold a grudge, but I'm not buying this basketball stuff. I mean, two people were going to go so far as to become roommates while still be angry at one another. I don't think so. Another thing I couldn't get past. Someone cut in line. Big deal. They couldn't have held hands after the ride. And still another. That was Sabrina's plan for revenge? And it worked? It just didn't add up. It was a long shot, but there was one person who might hold the key to figuring all of this out once and for all.
Grace, do you have any raw footage of the trip?
Did you see my new vlog?
Yeah.
Did you like it?
Yeah, it was fine. Can you get me to the point at the pier where everyone's waiting in line for the Ferris wheel?
Sure. Where's the tripod? Hold on a second. Oh, thank you. I really like the red on it. Yeah. And the legs are really... Oh, thank you. I really like the red on it. Yeah.
So it was you. You pushed her.
What?
You pushed her.
I did not push her.
Yeah, you did. I saw it was you.
That came out of my face.
No, no, dude.
To me, it's crystal clear. Upset that Abby did not reciprocate his feelings, and perhaps a little embarrassed that he had expressed them so plainly on Grazy H's vlog, Jamie conspired to ruin Abby's chances with Austin. Whether the Sabrina-Abby friendship would remain collateral damage was up to them.
I'm telling you, this is it. This works.
Seriously, what's she doing here?
Oh, I would have never come if I knew you were coming.
No, please, please. Just sit and watch. This explains just about everything. You see, Jamie set this up. He pushed you.
That doesn't prove anything.
Well, I saw your Finsta post, by the way.
Okay, so you still want on the Ferris wheel with him?
Well, I'm not the one who asked him. He asked me.
And so it goes. I thought that the clip made it an open and shut case. That a villain was found out, a friendship restored, and some positive memories of a trip could be salvaged. What I didn't realize is that not all tea spills are the same. And once that tea is spilled, you'd better not be around, or you're going to get burned.
Thank you again very much for attending. Have a wonderful rest of the charity week. This is the best week of the year at Athens, and I'm so happy that it is back. Enjoy and go Hawks.